Welcome, everybody, to the loudest podcast on the internet. I'm your host, Asterios Kokonos. With us, as always, is Sarancha.
Hello, Asterios, hello.
Hi, how you doing?
I'm good. I have thought up a new game for us to play on this show. It combines two of my favorite things, Wikipedia and randomly showing you gross things. How do you feel? You want to play?
No.
Okay, well, too bad. You're going to play the game.
Okay.
So here's the game. So on Wikipedia, I learned recently, one of my favorite hobbies is just trolling around Wikipedia and randomly searching for things. Like, I love to hit the random article button. I somehow discovered there's an article on Wikipedia called the Bad Images List.
The Bad Images List.
The Bad Images List. Now, okay. The Bad Images List is a list of images, like links to images on Wikipedia. Each image in the bad image list has some type of accepted use on Wikipedia.
Okay.
In some context. However, it is also a target for vandalism. So, if you want to post these bad images, an admin has to do it and decide, like, where they go.
So these images, sorry to interrupt. So these images are so toxic that they've been put up on a high shelf by the admins. It's like, no one is allowed to touch these images.
That's exactly right.
Okay.
And it's fun because the images, the bad image list, it's in just a list of bullet points.
Okay.
File, dot, and then the name of the thing. Now, a lot of them, you could probably guess what the image is. For example, balltorture.jpg.
Yep. No underscore, no date at the end, just the word ball, the word torture.jpg.
No, I'm sorry, 00 ball underscore torture, because there are multiple ball torture.
Are you? Okay. Do me a favor, actually. Go to the ball torture Wikipedia page right now and just tell me how many ball torture images are on there.
Sure.
We are. I just want to let you know. Last week, we got demonetized because the Ranchoisms have been encroaching and invading on the Magic Minute, depriving it of its magic.
Okay, there are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 images on the Ball Torture Wikipedia page, and I recognize a lot of these because I saw them clicking through the bad images list coming up with this game.
Okay.
So here's the... Now, some of them make sense, but a lot of them do not make sense. So I have created a list. These are all items on the bad images list. And if you can guess what the image is, then you don't have to look at it. But if you fail, then I'm going to make you look at it. Okay?
It sounds kind of like I don't have a choice. Look, this is the problem.
I'm listening.
It's clear that you've put a lot of work into this game. On the other hand, I don't want to play it. How about this? I'll give you a couple of questions, and then we'll see how I feel.
Okay, round one, four fingers.
My guess is that it is four fingers of a pour. It is two fingers times two. It's showing you how you would pour a shot, but instead of two fingers of Glenlivet, it's four fingers of Glenlivet. It's a double.
No, it's this.
Oh, what? Hey, hey! You can't show that on the camera!
Oh, shit, I forgot. Okay, yeah, sorry, YouTube. Sorry, YouTube! We gotta keep this too hot for YouTube.
You can't! Rancho just gawked her... Oh, no, 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 you also can't show it to me!
You have to describe it to people. They want to know what four fingers is. This isn't a visual format.
It's a... Look, from what I've seen, from what I've seen, I did manage to close my eyes, turn it around so I could open my eyes again. Rancho showing it to me on her laptop. I don't see any fingers there. It's just a big phallus, a human's phallus.
You didn't look close enough.
Well, I'm trying not to look. Look, someone's being fucked in the ass, okay, with a big dick.
It's not a big dick. It's someone putting four fingers into a vagina.
That's four fingers?
Yes. Okay, round two. You have no points right now. HippieHollow.jpg.
A hippie hollow.
HippieHollow.jpg.
Okay, now, you mind if I give two guesses?
Give me your first one, and then depending on how bad it is, I'll decide.
Well, how about this? It's Hollywood Squares rules. Joke and then real answer.
Okay, deal.
Okay. The joke is obviously that this is some sort of 1960s game of Ookie Kookie, where a bunch of hippies have gathered in a hollow to drench something. And then the last person to gotta eat it. I think the real answer is that it's like a secret bong in a book. And it's like, this is my hippie hollow, dude. So it's like someone has turned like a regular thing, like a calculator. Or I hate how you're smiling and you're already turning the thing around. Can you just let me? Listeners,
you're not even remotely close.
Well, what it should be is a hollowed out thing that a hippie can hide their weed in. So it should be like a Bible and it got a bong in it, or a calculator and it's got a bong in it.
Okay, well, you're completely wrong. And so you're going to have to, I'm going to show you Hippie Hollow, and then you have to describe Hippie Hollow.jpg to the listeners. Ready? 1, 2, 3.
What's happening there? I can't really tell what's happening there. Okay, tilting the monitor is not helping me understand.
How are you not understanding this?
It's because it can't be this simple. Okay, look, it's a hippie. You could tell. It does look like the Doctor Who that wears the scarf from the back. And they're out in a meadow. They've got a hippie hat on. They're nude. They're bent over. And they're inserting one of their digits into their anus?
No, not their anus. Their vagina.
Are all these going to be about vaginal insertion?
No, actually. Amazingly. Okay. This is game_pad.jpg.
No. Rancho, you have to explain what a hippie hollow is.
I don't know what it is.
Why don't you click on it and find out what it is? We're supposed to be educating the listeners.
It's weird because this one doesn't have it doesn't have a link to anything.
Well, then find out.
I don't know where
why
this
don't you Google
is
hippie
posted.
Hollow. Google it. Wiki it.
Cock and ball.
I at least want to leave this game with something.
Oh, God. The first thing that comes up is a public park. I hope that wasn't taken there.
The Hippie Hollow might be a park where hippies go and fool around, which is a lot like what I said in my first answer.
Okay, our next one is
you still
game
haven't
pad.
Told us what a hippie hollow is.
Well, I don't understand your question.
What is a hippie hollow?
I don't know.
I'll look it up then.
Okay, do it.
Fine.
Fucking do it.
Yeah. How hard is this? Hippie Hollow Park has a long tradition.
I sure hope this wasn't taken in that public park. I said that 30 seconds
there's
ago?
There's a difference between someone taking a nude photo in a public park and Hippie Hollow Park, which is in Travis County, Texas.
I don't even know that this is Hippie Hollow Park.
It has a long tradition of being the only clothing optional public park in Texas. Entry to the park is restricted to those 18 years and older. And here we go. Lone Star Party Boat Rentals, LakeTravis.com. Hippie Hollow is a public park. It's operated by Travis County. $8 a person, $3 for seniors, $0 for disabled veterans. Or you could have just gone to the Wikipedia page for Hippie Hollow Park, which I have up here. Originally known as McGregor Park, it's off the shore of Lake Travis in northwest Austin. Austin, Texas. Now this makes sense. That's where the freaks are. It's a state governmentally recognized nudist park. Is that not interesting to you?
That is.
I'm sorry that that fact doesn't have someone shoving a finger up their gooch, but it's interesting to some of us.
I didn't know it was a naked park. That makes it a little better, but I'm pretty sure you're still not allowed to masturbate there. So I don't know why this image is educationally important.
Maybe her fingers were cold and she was just trying to warm them up inside her hippie hollow.
Listen, it does get cold down there.
It's Texas. It gets cold at night.
game_pad.jpg.
Okay. Now the gross answer, that it's someone sticking a game pad in their anus. But I like to believe that the real answer is that someone put electrodes in their skin or on their dick and they found a way to control Mario with their cock. And so like when they make their cock twitch, Mario jumps. And when they get erect, Mario becomes the big Mario, the Super Mario.
That's
you
really
close. You know Super Mario?
Yes.
Okay, because you know the tall version of Mario is called Super Mario.
I have played Super Mario Brothers 2. That's the Game Boy Advance one, right?
No, but that's okay. We'll just move on.
Anyways, you're wrong.
But I'm wrong!
But you're close. Okay, ready? This is gamepad.jpg.
Again, it's too simple. I thought that was the first thing I thought.
Yeah, you thought it.
And then I was like, it's too simple. It's a nude lady's butt, and she's drawn the D-pad on the side. Look, either she or someone else is drawing. And if she's drawn this, she has incredible limb control.
Reach.
She's drawn it, the D-pad on the left buttock, and then the four PlayStation icons on the right buttock. Look, my first thought when you said gamepad was like, I remember in the 2000s, there would be like Playboys, like gamers of the web, and like, it would just be like hot girls with like gamepads over their nipples and pussies and stuff. Okay, so it's just that.
Yeah, the description is a woman's bum with video game controller icons painted on her. Her back is arched such that you can see her vagina. Where is this?
Click.
Where is this used?
I bet there's a way that you can click these links and kind of with one or two hops bring us to their context.
I found, okay, it is linked on Russian Wiki News, Star Mobile Phones, Ekasi Petalev. Oh, wow. He did a series.
Yeah.
He did a series like this.
Yeah, you see, this is what I'm saying. Okay, and then now Rancho's turned around. It's another nude model, but she's got the android alien on her back, and then her butt has some of the android, like, go back to the previous page or, like, expand. It's weird. It doesn't really work with the android one because the icons drawn on the butt are just for, like, very simple navigation and not for fun.
Okay, here's one. Here's a freebie round. I feel bad that you haven't gotten any correct, so I'm going to give you a freebie round. Ready?
Okay.
Gay underscore anal underscore and underscore handjob. Touch it, Beck.
Why would they be on the same page? Okay, I guess they're from the page that is just about gay sex acts.
Close.
But again, it's like, it can't just be that a guy is getting rammed in his butt while giving a hand job to another guy. It's like, do we need an image I just don't know that we would need an image for these kind of like combos. You know what I mean? I understand a page for anal. I understand a page for hand jobs. I don't know why we need one image to cover off on all this.
Yeah, it doesn't really look like he's giving a hand job per se, more so grabbing his dick. It's a guy bent, he's on his back with his like knees over his head and his butt and testicles. You could see them. And there's another man on top of him, both giving him a hand job and putting his penis.
So it's a reach around.
Yeah. No.
Oh.
Not exactly, because I don't know. Is that a reach around where, like, okay, you're laying like this.
Okay, please don't use what. Put while they're down.
How would you like me to do this, then?
I already understand it. I get it. The guy's getting fucked, and then the guy fucking the guy is giving the guy getting fucked a hand job.
And this is on the Portuguese page for barebacking. For barebacking in Portuguese specifically.
I feel like, and look, if I'm wrong, I'm wrong, Rancho.
I'm listening.
I feel like a reach around is kind of like the extra sprinkles. You know what I mean? Can you give someone a reach around and have that be the whole thing? Yes. But I feel like it's most commonly like comboed. What do you think?
I don't know. I don't think that's fair to call that a hand job. Like, it feels like just an accoutrement. Like, it's something you buy as an add-on. It's like the plane ticket is the main event. The anal sex is the main event.
Yeah.
But, like, I'm giving you a hand job, too. It's like, I don't know if we should distinguish. I had anal sex and got a hand job. Like, you wouldn't, it's just not worth mentioning, I feel like.
Look, I'm just going to Google what a reach around is on Wikipedia.
It's when you're getting your ass ate and... Wait, I thought rusty trombone, is that the same thing?
No, this is interesting. I very quickly realized we both had very different definitions of what a reach around was.
Who's right?
Well, Wikipedia's right. A reach around is manual stimulation of a sexual partner's genitals during anal or vaginal intercourse from behind.
Oh, I didn't know that.
So this could be like a thing where if a guy is having sex with a lady from behind, he can reach around and, you know, grab a handful of the good stuff. And then it's like, it's a reach around.
I was super excited when I found this bad images page because it reminded me of the first time I saw Encyclopedia Dramatica when I was in like sixth grade. Because they used to have a page that was like, click here if you would like to submit a complaint. And then you scrolled, it was just a bunch of pictures of dead bodies. like to get to the complaint submission form, you had to scroll through a bunch of disgusting pictures of like sex acts and dead bodies. And this is kind of what that reminded me of, because you really do. You sometimes get things that make sense, and other times you get hippies fingering themselves in a meadow.
You know what's weird to me?
What?
That what you just described, the idea of having to scroll past like corpse after corpse in order to get to a form, is from when the internet was a more innocent time.
It really was.
It's like, just remember the good old vanilla days of trolling, where if you wanted to click on something, you'd click on it, and then there'd be a person stretching their anus as far as they possibly could. I'm nostalgia for Goatsy.
Yeah. No, somebody asked me, do you know, or they did goats in text, and was like, ha ha, Sarantia, guess what this is? I'm like, do not quote the ancient text to me, witch. I know exactly what you're talking about. You want to see the image it comes from?
It's so weird, because I'm thinking about Goatsy, and it's like, there was a lot of stuff that was wrong up there.
Up there on the internet?
No, up there, up the ass.
Oh, yeah. I mean, I don't know what the inside of, to be fair, I don't know what the inside of a rectum should look
like. It should not look like that. It's like, there was stuff wrong up there.
All right, one more, Asterios, one more. Okay. All right. You can get this one. Okay. If you, I believe in you, you can get this one. Okay. High and loose. .jpg.
No. No.
What do you mean no?
Don't. You made me think of a thing. No.
What?
If anything's loose, it's an anus. Right?
No.
That's the funniest thing that's loose. So it's like a prolapsed anus, and it's been tucked back up there, kind of like when... when you shove a garden hose in the garden shed real fast but without winding it up. And so there's just like a lot of distended anus. It's like a ball of poorly organized anal tissue.
I'm sorry, it's serious. You're 0 for 5. It's a PP. It's just a penis. Just a flaccid penis.
I have to say, okay, so clearly what is high and loose are the balls.
Yeah, I think
like,
so.
That is what is high and loose here. And those balls are high and loose. I have to say, that's the most vanilla cock I've ever seen in my life. If there was any penis that Wikipedia should use as just like the standard penis, it's that. Would you like to describe that penis?
Yeah, it looks like his balls. I didn't know the balls could move at different speeds. Like, I thought they both had to be either up or down. Like, in or out.
They usually, as you age, they each start to get a mind of their own, and I'm not kidding when I say this. And it's concerning and frightening, but don't worry, death solves it.
That's, wow, that's fucking crazy. So many problems with your scrotum and ass. Why are these made this way? It's like, what's a prostate? It just gets cancer and then you die? That's
no, it's straight. A prostate is kind of the thing that soups up your sperm. It turned your sperm into semen.
Oh, I thought it just made you cum super hard.
I mean, look, I've been told it does. I keep thinking about that. About, you know, the male G-spot.
Yeah.
It just seems like too much work.
You think so?
It better be worth it. Look, if one day I'm like, you know what, Rancho? I think it might be time to push my button. It better be the greatest feeling I've ever had.
I've heard it's really good.
Yeah, but everyone says that about everything. Oh, it's the best movie. Oh, this is the best Italian dinner. Oh, you'll come so hard, you'll fucking die. It's like, yeah, yeah, yeah. I feel like people who are into ass play are talking it up a lot to try to rope the rest of us into it, too.
I mean, that's true. Yeah, that is true. That's fair. That's a fair assessment of ass people, because they never shut the fuck up
they
about it.
They don't shut the fuck up about it, exactly. It's like those fucking orgy people with those documents I was telling you about before.
What? Oh my God, tell me about that.
I saw this like on Twitter the other day. It's one of the few times like I've enjoyed being on Twitter. This lady's been having orgies for a while, and so she like eventually developed like a Google Doc to explain like all the rules of the orgy before you got there, which kind of makes sense to me because it's like, well, you know, we should all be on the same page before we show up. Like, we shouldn't all show up to someone's apartment with like wildly different expectations of what we're allowed to do.
Yeah, I mean, totally. You don't, that totally completely ruins the mood when you show up to the orgy and then suddenly somebody's got their finger on your butt and you're like, I didn't say that.
And you're like, I am not wearing the blue bracelet. I am wearing the green bracelet. Get your fingers out of there.
Get your fingers out of that hole.
Yeah. So someone got their, like, orgy Google Doc stolen, and they're upset. I'll just read the thing.
Yeah, read the thing.
Yeah, okay, so here we go. This is a post that was on Instagram. And it says, "Hi, Matthew. It's come to my attention that you are co-hosting a play party on Friday."
Gross.
Why is that a grosser term than orgy?
Yeah, just say orgy. At least just say orgy. Play party. That's how, because it sounds like play date, which is kids.
Yes, that's exactly right. While that's all well and good, it's abundantly clear that your informational Google Doc was directly lifted from the one I wrote.
Wow.
The version history starts with a copy of the Tea Time file. Oh my God, this person went into Matthew's Google Doc version history. You should not have your version history open, Matthew. I do not know why you sent out this link editable.
You got to have your evidence ready. Otherwise, he could refute these and claim that he copied his pet play words or whatever the fuck.
Matthew, you should have sent out a PDF. It's a nice flat file. Obviously, the version history starts with a copy of the Tea Time file. Although some specifics have been changed, the formatting and some of the language, even entire paragraphs, are verbatim. As I was not asked for permission to use nor share my work, nor credited, nor compensated, I consider this a theft of my intellectual property and labor.
I fucking hate the internet. Why are people like this allowed? But like, whenever I see screeds like this, it's like the longer it took to type out, it makes me think, wow, like you get fired up and angry about something and you start getting mad and you start typing like that gif of Kermit smashing the keyboard over and over again. But eventually you lose steam and you go back to normal. And then you're like, oh, this is kind of embarrassing. But man, this person just plowed through this whole letter. And without realizing how fucking crazy they sounded, even a little bit.
They also didn't just send it to Matthew. They screenshotted it and posted it on their own Instagram stories to double shame Matthew in the play community.
Oh my God, there's always such amazing, like, little drama going on with, like, poly and orgy people.
It just seems like so much work. Is having more than one sex partner really worth, like, all the scheduling and hassle? You have to text multiple people back. And God forbid, like, if you text one of them before the other one and then they see it and they're hanging out together, it's like, why do you like you more than me? It's like, is having two sex partners or three sex partners or four sex partners worth all the work? I don't think so.
It has to be your entire hobby. Like, because you, most people have to go to work. And then this is, like, what you do after work is you manage your poly. Cool. Some people have Sims. Other people have fuck partners.
I don't know this for a fact, but I guarantee these polycules all have like a Slack, and there's like the house Slack, and it's not on Discord. I swear to God it's on Slack, because these orgy people seem like they would be Slack people.
No, it's definitely on Discord. You're on drugs. It's absolutely on Discord, and everybody's got an anime profile.
I'm just going to say this about Discord. We should just get rid of it. It is not worth the hassle.
I do not like Discord.
I don't like Discord. A, I don't like that I have another email to check. Or, like, I haven't been on Discord in months. But B, it's just like, it's where the pedos are. I don't know what we lose for getting rid of. Like, I hate that I have, like, nieces and nephews that have Discord accounts. It's like,
oh my God, they have Discord?
Of course they do.
They can't have Discord. There's pedophiles.
That is how they get together and play like Minecraft or whatever together. And I remember being like, is it worth it to have like your Minecraft and or Roblox like hangouts be a little bit more convenient? And also there's pedos just like brute forcing their way into these Discords.
All right, I need to talk. Everybody, this is a message for Asterios' brother in particular. Everybody else turn off the podcast for a couple minutes. You got to get them off Discord, bro. You got to get them. Do they not have phones? Have them call one another. Is three-way calling not a thing anymore?
I just feel like they could all be on a group text.
There's other
ways to do this.
WhatsApp. Everybody can get on a WhatsApp call.
Look. The thing with 4chan, where it's like, yes, did 4chan ruin the election? Yes. Has 4chan, like, kind of made it impossible for women to exist on the internet? Yes. At least they gave us Bowsette.
They made that up?
Bowsette is a 4chan creation.
Oh, I didn't know that. Anyways, yeah, you got to get your fucking kids off Discord, because it's the place where pedophiles, it's like pedophile central. It's mecca for pedophiles. I would guess that probably 30% of Discord's user base is pedophiles.
If I'm looking to... If I'm the bad guy here, I am spending all day friending people on Discord and trying to break into various Discord servers. It's just like, what do they have to lose? It's like, that's where the oil is. It's like, where do you dig for gold? Where the gold is.
Yeah, where do you dig for kids? Where the kids are. They're on Discord. The other 30, 60% probably kids want to play Minecraft.
I consider this a theft of my intellectual property and labor. I have archived the document as proof of plagiarism. I am requesting the following actions for accountability.
Wow.
Says Christian to Matthew. By noon, Thursday, February 13th, 2024, between the TLDR and the theme sections, you update the Google Doc as follows. This document was based on one written by Kristen V8. She put her full name in this?
Oh my God.
This is how proud she is of this Google Doc. She's like, I'm going to post this, and not only am I put Matthew on blast, I'm going to become famous amongst orgy bureaucrats.
Having your government name, like, willingly attached to this shit is really crazy to me.
Yeah, I'm not reading the government name. Of Tea Time. I guess Tea Time is how they've branded their orgies.
Is that what they call just having sex in a pile now? Is that what the kids call it?
It's capital T in tea. It's a capital T in time. They're branding it. An earlier version didn't properly credit their language and contributions. We'd like to acknowledge this misstep in using their work without permission or compensation. Now, look, honestly, this doesn't seem like that big of a deal. Just put in a little quick edit. No one's reading this Google Doc. They're all way too boned up to fuck people at this, to fuck other fat slobs at this orgy, right? They're not reading this Google Doc.
This is an extension of a trend I've seen of people being like, my work didn't get me credit for this. It's like, how the fuck? I saw somebody like, yeah, I actually came up with Spotify Wrapped and they didn't give me any credit. It's like, what do you want? Be Spotify Wrapped by Jennifer.
Look, I get that we all deserve more credit. When I do my work for a corporation and like I say something and it ends up like as a big like TV commercial, it's like, what are they going to do? Put like a picture at the end of it of like me giving a thumbs up? It's like, the paycheck is the credit.
Yeah, the paycheck is the credit. Sorry, guys.
Yeah. No, but look.
The cum is the credit in this case.
Look, here's where it gets bad. During opening circle, which I did not know was a thing.
Opening circle jerk. Da 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 da. Sounds like a Wheel of Fortune puzzle.
Wait! That's a before and after, right? What do they call those?
Yeah, before and after.
Da da da
da da. Wow.
God damn it. I didn't know the joke you were making. I was confused, and now I think that might be one of the best things that's ever been said.
Well, that's my imitation. Listener, that's my imitation of the end of a Wheel of Fortune puzzle.
But it's clearly the mobile game version, because it was a TV, you'd have gone, da na na.
Yeah, no, you're right. It is the mobile version.
I just like that you put in, like, the royalty-free Wheel of Fortune correct song. Da na da na da.
Da.
During opening circle, you will make a similar statement to the group.
Wow.
You will record audio or video of yourself doing so and send it to me by 5 p.m. Sunday, February 18th. Please avoid including other attendees for their privacy. Oh, now we're worried
about
other
people. Now we care about privacy. Wow.
Also, Sunday, 5 p.m., what if this thing's become an all-nighter? Like, what if this party's become a rager?
Yeah, no, I mean, I guess he expects him to just do the opening circle and film it and then be like, all right, guys, I know we're all horned up and ready to bum, but hang on, I gotta email this file real quick. It's uploading. Wait, guys, please don't start sucking each other yet.
Give me 1 second. I have to go to GoSendIt.com, register for a free account.
Oh, damn it. Hongfire doesn't exist anymore. I don't know where I'm going to upload this.
Can I borrow someone's Dropbox for a minute so I can upload this file and send someone a private link only?
Excuse me, you with the tail? Do you have a Google Drive account? Mine is full.
Of blank.
Porn.
I'm also
on Discord.
Hey, God damn it. By 5 p.m. Sunday, February 18th, 2024, any contributed funds or material donations will be reported as my work, at least in part, helped elicit attendance and donations. I may ask for compensation, My Venmo is at Lunara. Oh my fucking God. It's an orgy shakedown.
Oh my God, it is. It's like, this is how the mob operates.
They want orgy royalties for their orgy Google Doc. I have thus far kept this information private. If these requests are not satisfied by the deadline provided, I will take action to make public statements about your theft of my work and how I see it demonstrating a pattern of undervaluing the labor of queer femmes. Thank you for your expected cooperation. And then it is tagged Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, but with the rainbow Philadelphia, Pennsylvania tag.
Oh, fucking awesome. Yeah, this would happen in Philadelphia.
Angry Philly orgy people are ripping each other to shreds on Instagram stories. This is fantastic.
This is great. This is exactly like when Comcast threatened me to stop downloading Sex in the City. They were like, if you don't stop this right now, you will get another letter. And it will be mean.
I did not notice this Philadelphia thing in the bottom corner. This has real fucking Philly energy. Can't you see, like, Kristen showing up at Matthew's orgy and just throwing batteries left and right, and those batteries getting stuck in places they don't belong?
In college, I knew a girl who had a tail, and she grew up in Philadelphia. So, yeah, I think it's the water.
And when you say had a tail, what do you mean?
I mean, she had like an anime tail that she would wear outside of her home.
Okay. Did she look cool in it?
No. Okay. Nobody looks cool in a tail.
You know, Halloween... Sexy devil tail. Cute.
No, we're not. Halloween doesn't count. Halloween's a very clear and obvious exception.
I'm trying to think if there are any tails that I
is
think
is there
are
any
cute.
Casual tails
yes.
that you would think are cute?
Halloween, sexy cat costume, girl holding her tail, spinning around like a lasso, going, I can't wait to get my claws on you. Sexy.
Yeah, no, that's a thing, Asterios. People are actually into is tails. Like, some people have a tail fetish. Did you know that? They want humans to have tails. This is sick. And our schools are teaching them that. And Joe Biden wants to teach them that more.
I swear to God, my first thought when you said this lady has a tail, I went to college with someone with a tail. With that, I don't know, they had like a little extra bone. Like, I thought it was like a physical. My mind did not go to furry shit.
No, it wasn't like a growth abnormality. She chose the tail.
Okay, look. I could pay attention to what you're saying about tails. Or I could hide.
Welcome to the push game.
I bought that off TikTok shop.
Yeah! Push game!
Round one. Why is it British?
I assumed it
to have the same voice as every Bluetooth, but this one is British, interestingly.
I was amazed when, because Rancho explained, she was like, I got you this thing. It's very popular on TikTok. I, of course, had never heard of it. And I was amazed when it started speaking perfect English, because the way my Bluetooth headphones, my cheap Bluetooth headphones speak to me, sounds a lot like a Matt Stone or Trey Parker character, if you
yeah.
know what I mean.
Oh, yeah. When my Bluetooth headphones disconnects, it says... The Bluetooth device is connect successfully.
Really good work.
Thank you.
Really. That was the cleanest, clearest read. That was incredible.
The Bluetooth device is connect successfully.
Mine sometimes will go, because, you know, I got like a little Bluetooth radio I listen to in the shower.
Yeah.
Sometimes it'll go, low battery, please charging.
Mine also says low battery, please charging.
Okay. All right. Speaking of low battery. I'm going to take a break and get myself a cup of coffee, and we'll be right back after this with more of The Loudest Podcast. Welcome back to The Loudest Podcast. All right, look, this episode is disgusting.
This episode is really bad.
Yeah. Oh, I wonder whose fault that is. You brought in this game. Immediately, the first thing you show me is that.
Listen, it's not my fault you're not good at guessing what anal sex is.
I did know what a reach around was, and you didn't.
That's true. You did. You have one up on me there.
And also, I said that it's an add-on to the combo meal, and I was right. The Wikipedia said you can't just reach around. You got to be doing another thing.
Reach around is such a funny word.
Of course it is. Now, look. This is not funny, what I'm about to say, which is the other morning, it's like, I don't want to get out of bed. I was up until 2 in the morning the night before, writing a bunch of tweets for like a water company. And it's like, I'm trying to save up money for this wedding. I'm trying to put away a lot of money. So I'm taking like a lot of little jobs right now. And I'm up till 2 a.m. So I don't want to wake up. Rancho's like, you gotta wake up. Like, you can't just stay in bed. Like, you got meetings. So she brings me a cup of coffee. And she's like, hey, come out to the living room. Like, we'll watch some American Dad. I'll give you a cup of coffee. Like, I'll help you wake up. And I was like, this is my dream woman. Like, my future wife. Like, helping me, like, get out of bed. Help me be a more productive person and a better man. So I sit down in my little lounge chair. She hands me a cup of coffee that she made herself. And she goes, hey, you want to read the scientific paper I found about slawed off hemorrhoids? And I almost throw up the coffee. My stomach is already like full of acid all the time now because I'm so stressed with all these goddamn odd jobs I'm doing. And I'm drinking this coffee and I'm like, I go, oh, never say those words again. What are you doing? It's 10 in the morning and I'm in the middle of texting my mom. And you know I text my mom every morning because you make fun of me for texting my mom every morning.
Well, excuse the fuck out of me for trying to infuse your morning with humor because that's fucking hilarious.
What is so funny about that?
Okay, because it evokes the image of, first of all, listener, it was not a scientific paper about slot off hemorrhoids. It was a scientific paper. I have been recently obsessed with reading about these things called, I don't know how to pronounce it, bezoars, I don't remember, but they're masses of material that gather in your digestive system and nobody can shit them out. So they go to the hospital and then they have to go in there and pull it out of your ass, which I think is hilarious. So one of the common materials that will cause these is sunflower seeds. Listener, there are people out there eating entire bags of sunflower seeds with the shell. Even birds don't eat them with the shell.
You may remember bezoars, listeners, from our Hamtaro episode, because Rancho was like, even hamsters, the dumbest creatures on earth, the creatures that eat their own kids, know to take off the sunflower seed shell. Because Hamtaro does. He cracks the shell off and he goes, nom, 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 much, much, much.
He does. Well, there's a group of people in the world just eating entire bags of them. And that will put you in the hospital if you eat an entire bag of sunflower seeds. Because your body can't digest the sunflower seed. So it clumps together with other digestive materials and forms this gigantic Indiana Jones-like boulder in your ass. So, I was reading this paper about one of these boulders and the removal of said sunflower seed boulder, and they said, and I quote, after digital inspection of the anus, we discovered slot-off hemorrhoids. And that, to me, it says, why did you need to include that? Like, that has nothing to do with the sunflower seed mass moving through their digestional tract or failing to move through their digestional tract, I guess. And it's also incredibly funny to me. So everything involving your ass is automatically some level funny, right? It's extra funny because to me, slot off hemorrhoids, what that means is somebody put soap or exfoliator on a loofah and so violently scrubbed their ass that they chafed them off.
Look.
That's hilarious.
Look, we can debate whether or not this is funny all night. I refuse to. Where are you finding these scientific papers? Like, what do you mean? Like, how are you finding these scientific papers about sunflower seed masses in asshole?
Oh, okay. Let me tell you. So you can start by, there's a bunch of free ones that you can find on the internet. You can start there. But as you run out of material, as I have, because sometimes they take pictures. I love when they send the colonoscopy thing up there to take pictures of the sunflower seed mass. Because what they always have to end up doing is putting the person to sleep and then going into their ass and pulling it out.
And they have to put the person to sleep, Rancho has explained to me, in many car rides recently, because it's just too painful. Like, they can't remove these masses while the person is awake. They're screaming in pain. Imagine Pinhead from the Hellraiser movies just stuck up there. Like, you're not getting Pinhead out without some trouble.
It's so interesting because I watched, or I read one of them where they were like, okay, let's try, what's it called? Something that makes you diarrhea first. And that didn't work. It just, like, the shards of sunflower seeds were just still in there.
I can understand the logic behind it because they're like, you know, maybe we can get the party started and then it'll kind of take care of itself. It also, to me, kind of sounds like that episode of It's Always Sunny where, like, a bunch of kids got, like, stuck in the slide and their solution is just to send more kids down. It's like, yeah, look, that might clear the clog.
Eventually it'll pop out.
Or you might kill even more kids.
So, listeners, if there ever a paper on something that you want to read but you don't want to pay for, like on PubMed or something, here's a little tip. Email whoever the author is. Like 90% of the time, they're associated with some school. You can look them up on their page. Find their email. Send it and be like, hey, I really want to read your paper about Bayswater sunflower seeds in ass, but I just can't afford the fee right now. Do you think you could send me a copy? 100% of the time I have done that, they have said yes and sent it over. They don't care. They don't get any money from that. Do you know that? When people buy people's papers online, they don't get any money.
Yes, yes. Look, the ethics of royalties and scientific publishing is fascinating. You're spending your free time emailing scientists that have written sunflower seed ass papers and been like, can you send me the unredacted full paper for free?
Everybody says women don't have hobbies. And then a woman has a hobby and you people freak the fuck out. Amazing. Yes. Listen, I could be playing a guitar or driving a race car, but you know what? These sunflower seeds and asses are so fucking funny.
How did you originally find out about Bayswaters? Was it a thing where you were just like on Wikipedia clicking random?
Yes. Uh-huh.
Really?
Yes. What originally started it was I learned about tonsil stones on Wikipedia, which are like crazy. And I was like, what are the other weird things can get stuck in your body different places?
There's a Wikipedia article called Stuff That Can Get Stuck In You?
No, that was more of my inspiration when searching for things. And that's how I discovered is I'm trying to find about things that can get stuck in the human body.
Maybe next time Jimmy Wales asks for $3, I'm going to say no. We might not need Wikipedia after all, now that I think about it. Democratizing all information, putting it in all languages, and making it available for free is not worth it if it has ruined my fiancé, where she's trying to find increasingly grosser and grosser internal masses.
Well, listen, I don't think that Wikipedia is responsible for ruining. I think your fiancé was ruined by the internet long before that. I think your fiancé's frontal lobe was melted at a very crucial time in her life.
It's so weird. Listener, she looks so adorable. Right now, no joke, she's wearing pajamas that are like fuzzy teddy bear pajamas. What are those, a sheep or are they a teddy bear?
No, it's a teddy bear.
Yeah. The pockets are two smiling teddy bears. So she could put her sleep mask in one and, like, you know, her little vape in the other. She wears pink fuzzy slippers. She loves birds. But the first thing she'll tell me at 10 in the morning when I'm just waking up is, hey, these Bayswaters are so bad that when the razor sharp sunflower seeds do occasionally make their way out of the anus, they rip hemorrhoids off on the way out. Slaw them right off.
Not only are you so dramatic, but that's not even right. They discovered the slawed off hemorrhoids before they were able to get the sunflower seeds out. So it's implied that it was two separate instances, which is why I was like, why did you include this?
That is not.
That's not what sunflower seeds do. They don't fly out and slice your anus like razors.
That is exact. What the fuck are you talking? Of course the sunflower seeds slawed off these hemorrhoids. Otherwise, why would they be in the scientific paper? The scientist, the author, was saying, if you're seeing slawed off hemorrhoids, that might be a sign of a Bayswaters.
No.
These aren't unrelated issues.
I think he just thought it was funny that somebody slawed their hemorrhoids off like I did. I thought that was hilarious.
It's causal. It's clearly causal because it takes a while to develop a full Bayswaters. It's like a Katamari. It starts out small. So some of those sunflower seeds are going to escape. But as you continue to eat bag after bag of sunflower seeds, I assume because you're trying to lose weight, right? Is there any other reason to eat sunflower seeds?
Honest to God, I have no idea. And it's so interesting because it doesn't need weeks. You just have to eat one bag, entire bag of sunflower seeds with the shells on. That's the crucial part, with the shells
on. How big is this bag?
Like, yay big.
Oh, that is okay. Oh, no, I'm imagining all that stuck up there. Okay, it's about two fists in size. About two fists of sunflower seeds.
You know what else is going to be two fists in size?
I'm just saying, I don't think it's an immediate blockage. I think a couple of stragglers slip out and then slice and dice their way out before they lock the door. You don't think so?
No, I really do believe that somebody was like, my ass itches, I better clean it. So they would...
They would have to be like Brillo-ing their ass. It's like hemorrhoids aren't... If they could come off with just like a little bit of... Oh God, why am I talking about this?
They come off with a lot of effort. That's the point.
Yeah.
You slaw them off.
Pays war level efforts. You know what? You and I will never solve this. The only solution here... is to contact some of these authors and ask them to come on the Loudest Podcast.
Listener, please eat an entire bag of sunflower seeds with the shells, go to the hospital, get your ass bezoar removed, and then mail it to me. I want to see if it has blood on it.
You don't think it has blood on it?
It has to, right?
You know it's got blood on it. It's someone shitting out a spiny from Super Mario Brothers.
I don't know. Most of the pictures I've seen, it's been like digested material, but I can't tell if it's blood.
You know, okay, I'm just going to... Well, I'm going to talk about what I want to talk about. Lakitu.
Okay.
He's in that cloud. You think that cloud would be comfortable, but don't forget that cloud is full of spinies. I know that you, Sarantia, primarily know Lakitu as the camera person from the Super Mario Kart races.
I do.
Yeah, but originally, he's up there hurling like grenades at you. That's a very uncomfortable cloud he's sitting in. He's essentially flying around in a little cloud of base wars.
Is it possible that he's just generating them via magic when he needs them? Like, there are no spiny things that exist in his cloud, but he can summon them and then throw them as he needs them. Is he magic? Is that a possibility?
It's absolutely a possibility. I mean, look, you're essentially talking about, like, summoning them from Hammer Space, and I'm sure that's what it is. But I like to believe that he's producing them.
Oh, like he sits at home making them and is like, oh, this is going to hit.
He's up in the cloud, and he's like, there's Mario. Ha ha, take this, Mario. Oh, I missed. Oh, no, he launched some sort of ball of fire at it. Well, second time's a charm. Yeah! And that's why they're red.
Oh, yeah, I bet you're right.
And that's why we'll never talk about this again on the Loudest Podcast. We hope you've enjoyed this special spooky,
whatever the fuck this was,
gross out issue from the Garbage Pail Kids episode of the Loudest Podcast. Please leave a comment on the YouTube. It's so nice to read your little comments on the YouTube. It is so nice to get your little tweets and for people to be like, oh, I like the show. I did the show. Oh, I like this little part of the show. You reach out to us. I'm on Twitter at Asterios. Rancho doesn't go on her Twitter anymore, but I'll show her.
It's a hellscape.
If you tweet at me, or you know, you listen on YouTube, leave it in the comments. Leave a little comment in the Patreon. We got a couple of new patrons in the past couple of days because of, I like to think it's because I pointed out that with inflation, the $2 that it takes to get all of our bonus content is now like 35 cents, right? It's like 35 cents.
Exactly. And in 10 years' time, it'll be like 10 cents. You'll look back on these memories and be like, wow, I spent a nickel and I got real joy, just like your grandfather did when he went to the penny candy store and got a Now and Later and chewed it for hours and hours.
I was about to fucking bring up candy. The other day, I'm in the supermarket. I'm like, I'm trying to lose weight. We got a cruise coming up. I'll get a York pepper and patty, 150 calories, York pepper and patty. $2.49. For the shitty candy bar.
Oh, God. Inflation hurts us all.
Yeah, exactly. We got 170 bonus episodes. Or you could get most of a York pepper and patty, which is the bar that you buy as a compromise.
Exactly. This content doesn't taste like shit either.
Yeah, exactly. All right. That's it for the Loudest Podcast. We'll talk to you next time.
Bye.